Hi, this is Simon Chan, and welcome to my network marketing training. Members of my coaching mastermind groups can ask me questions on a weekly basis, and today's question comes from Jacko from Sydney, Australia, and Jacko is an advanced Diamond Mastermind member. So Jacko asks, and this is a long message, but something that's relevant to a lot of network marketers. So I want to read this, so pay attention. So Simon, thank you very much. Your marketing strategy has helped a lot, especially in developing my own USP, which means unique selling proposition. Okay, what makes you attractive to others? So USP basically means why in the world would someone join or buy from you? Okay, so Jacko has helped develop his own USP, which is international students who work hard and study hard and want more in life. Also, international students who play games and waste lots of time in stupid things in the past. And these people are my market. However, I really want to do my business full-time, and I don't find that myself are doing the productive stuff. Don't have enough people to talk to, don't have enough people for me to lead. All I do every day is basically walking around the city and trying to find random people to talk to. I think I've talked to over 300 people over the past 3 months and also got their numbers, but I only signed up one person so far. Even the person I signed up, she's doing so much better than me. She signed up more people than me. All I did was pretty much supporting her and giving her coaching materials and stuff. Even though I always try to stay positive in front of everyone and telling people that I'm doing great, I feel I should have that mindset. And every night I stay up late listening to motivational speeches and tape and hoping I can perform better the next day. But my goal is prospecting 2 people every day. So far I've got over 30 rejections after they came to the Health and Freedom presentation. Network marketing presentation. My upline helped me to follow up. When I said connecting to people, they'd rather reply to my SMS than picking my call. I found that it wasn't so effective. Anyway, I'll keep up with them, invite people to the meeting. The biggest challenge is that how do I go full-time in network marketing using the time effectively instead of walking around trying to prospect some strangers? I have a part-time job, 2 days a week. That's enough for my daily living because I don't have family and other expenses. I really want to plan my day more effectively, but sometimes I fail to get enough prospects even though I have my target audience. I think the 5 core production activities, I fail to do the follow-up on presentations but don't have enough potential prospects. It'd be great if you can give me any tips. All right, so you, first of all, Jacko, it's great that you're applying. I can tell you're working, you're into self-development, you've read, even the short time we're working together. I've seen you learn a lot of new things, and you're listening to motivational before you go to sleep, which is very, very helpful. And you're investing in yourself. It's going to your subconscious mind. That's awesome. Now, a couple of things. I absolutely agree you're not using your time productively. Okay, so a couple of things. In terms of getting people to talk to, if you're not investing time, you got to invest money. So there's a couple of ways to talk to people, to find people to talk to. Number one, you can talk to your warm market, right? And after you've talked to your warm market, exhausted already, then you have to, the other ways to do it is go out and meet new people. To meet new people at gyms, at restaurants, people out on the street. And I think you've talked to a lot of people on the street, which is great because I'm sure your personal people skills are way, way better than it was, right? That's one way to do it, just meet people out there. Benefit is it doesn't cost money. Downside is it costs you a lot of your time, and you're absolutely right. It may not be the most productive, and right now it's not productive for you. The second way is you can buy leads. Buy leads. There's lead brokers out there that sell leads. The positive, it saves you time. You just pay the money, they give you a list of people that they claim to be interested in having a home-based business, and then you can call them. The downside is a lot of these leads may not be good. Downside, it costs money, and the money is not that big a deal, but they may be terrible quality. Now, you may test them out, find out some lead brokers in Sydney. Maybe they have them, maybe they don't. Test them out, okay? I've had good but mostly negative experiences with lead brokers, people who sell leads. Now, the third way is the way I prefer, is doing your own marketing where you do your own advertising and to get leads. Now there's free and non-free, okay? There's 2 ways. The downside is it takes time and it requires money. The positive is the lead quality is way, way better, and these people are qualified already. So my initial reaction by reading your your message to me is that you know what your USP is, international students. Is there a way where you can advertise just only to international students? That little market, that niche. Advertise in not just your university. I would start off just your university first. Okay, start. That's where I start off. Is there a way to advertise and target only, because you probably don't know all of them, right? Advertise to them. Now, when you advertise, you gotta provide something of value. And that's what we talked about, the lead magnet, or your irresistible offer, right? Something of value. So for example, if you put so if you're advertising to international students, I don't know how your school is like, but where I went, Columbia, or where my wife went at Berkeley, there's sometimes dormitories where international students stay at. You can put flyers, put them all over there, right? There'll be forums, Facebook groups, advertise there, post up there. But the dorm, I mean, for me, it's like dorm, the international students stay at certain places, or maybe they have certain groups. Maybe there's like a Chinese group, there's a Korean group, there is a Japanese group, there's a Latino group, there's a French group, Spanish group. You know, find these international students. Maybe they have these clubs. When I say groups, they're clubs, right? Chinese club, Korean, I mean, back in university, I had a Korean club, Puerto Rican club, you know, Black African-American club. They do different things, right? Actually, they call BSO, Black Student Organization. Right, we have. So I would advertise flyers in those areas. Maybe they even have a newsletter where you can advertise. Now, that's one way. The second thing is when you gotta give them a reason why for them to contact you, right? So you can maybe, it's called an irresistible offer, right? Oh wow, it's so good, free tutoring or something that gets them to take action and to call you, to contact you. And you may even say, you know, you have to make a phone call, leave a voicemail. Don't do a text message, right, if you want to talk to them. I leave that up to you. You have to test it. But the irresistible offer also can be related to the business, meaning like, hey, learn to generate some part-time income. Right? You can maybe even advertise it as a job. Right? Advertise it as a job, like a part-time income, but, you know, no requirements, training provided, you know, work 5-10 hours a week. You know, or you work 5-10 hours a week to earn $100 a week, earn an extra $100-$200 a week to pay your school expenses. Whatever you come up, and we can talk more about it in the mastermind, but start thinking about that. You're going to create some advertising that will, so when people see the flyer, say, hey, wow, I have time, right? I'm going to pull it and call that number. Okay, and so that's one thing you can do. You focus on the easiest thing is to just focus on international students. If it does well, then maybe you expand to other students. Also, not just your school, maybe you want to do outside your school, right? Different schools. So you can say, recruiter, student from Sydney is also recruiting in Melbourne or recruiting another. I would just have a, or maybe just start in Sydney first, all the schools there, then go to Melbourne. Different places, right? You want to do places where you can meet these people. So, I'm sorry, I wouldn't say Melbourne. I don't know my geography well. I just realized Sydney and Melbourne are pretty far away. So, but it's something close to you, right? But start with your school first and in your local area. And since you know your USP, do advertising. And even if you don't have that, and it could be like a free report that you write, a 10-page, 15-page report that teaches how to generate part-time income on the side. And in our mastermind group, next time we can remind me, ask me questions that can go into more detail about that. And we will cover that in detail later on in probably late November, December. Anyway, about the lead magnet irresistible offer. But create something. Sit down there, you just have to write, it seems like you have time, write out something. And that, so when people call, they can get a free manual. Or maybe your students don't want a free manual because they're so sick of reading. You got to make a free CD. Something that, again, gets them to go out, or a free tutoring session. But it's something to give them the call to action, as you call it. Makes them see the ad, makes you want to call you. Why would they want to call you? And maybe you don't need to give something for free. Right? Maybe just like earn extra income, they'll call. But I think that's what you have to do. In the meantime, the fact that you're talking to other strangers out there, that's great for prospecting. Great. But really think about, now that you know your niche, how do you get these people? Right? Or, like I said, you know, using your time better, instead of talking to random strangers on the street, just talk to random, only random international students. Because that alone, you have something in common. If you talk to a random stranger in the street, they may be older, younger, nothing in common, right? If you have someone who's older, 50-year-old, who's a Caucasian lady, you probably have nothing in common. And she's probably, who the heck is this young man from China, right? But if you talk to just international students, strangers, maybe the person's also from China. Instantly you can connect. Or even the international students in France, but you're international students. You can talk about your challenges coming, going to new countries to study. So instantly you have a connection. So test those things out, Jacko. That's what I would do. We can cover more in detail. Ask me, let me know if you have any questions. And I think again, don't compare yourself to others. You have a great attitude. You will be successful. Don't worry about your downline who's not supporting. She's doing better than you. Go spend time with her. Find out why she's doing better than you. Right? Find out why she's doing better. Why, also, the people who are successful in your group, why are they successful? Why? What do they have that you don't have? What makes them attractive that you're not, that people are not attracting you? See if you can figure that out. And that again adds to your USP. When you copy, people say successful people, you copy what successful people do. Also copy what they are. What advantages and pros and cons do they have? And you may doesn't necessarily have to copy exactly what they do, but they have some advantages. So what are your advantages that they don't have? Right? And also you have disadvantages, weakness. But we don't worry about the weakness, we work on our strength. So you have a lot of strength, you have great work ethic, doing things a lot of people wouldn't do. You're willing to go through a rejection, that's great. So, but anyway, start thinking about it, you know your niche, start thinking about different ways to market to them. Okay? And then we can follow up more on our next mastermind call. Just bring it up and remind me. Alright everyone. And, for those who are out there, that's a very good call, very good question. You always have to be constantly increasing your contact database. Just don't say, these are my list, I'm going to talk to them. Because one day you will run out. That's why it's critical every day to add to that list. And like Jacko, when you're talking to these people who are not interested, that's okay, you keep their information. Because one day they may be interested. And the good thing you're doing, Jacko, you're increasing your database. Right? Now, some are not great quality contacts, some are quality contacts. I mean, the ones who show up for your meetings, those are probably, I would say, good quality contacts. Good enough that they showed up to your meeting. So you add to your database. And over time, your database, as your network grows, remember, your network is always your net worth. Right? So keep that in mind. So make sure everyone out there build new contacts every day. Not just worry about prospecting, but you got to expand your database. All right, everyone, I hope that's helpful. This is Simon Chan. Thank you for watching my network marketing training. Take care.